So, if you understand, let's jump right into this dungeon. And the mission's right down the road, so I might as well run, get my stamina. Well, not right down the road, but like in town. Yeah, it's right there.
Excuse me, sir. You work here?
No, I just hang around here for fun. I'm joking. How can I help you, friend?
I know this sounds crazy. Some dumb old coot I know is telling me there's these houses you can buy pre-cut.
Not crazy, friend. The very latest in modern convenience. Convenient and cost-efficient. Which house do you want? Each one is entirely unique, but also the same.
Excuse me?
Perhaps I'm going too fast, sir. Do you want to buy a house?
I think so.
I'll give you a luxurious, entirely unique, pre-cut palace. And if you order today, I guarantee your home in a matter of weeks, maybe sooner.
I'll take that one.
Ah, yes, we have that one in stock.
And I already got credit from the bank.
Oh, fantastic. You write your name here, and you sign your name there, and you will be the proud owner of a factory-built home.
Why is that paper so old? Did it just like erase thing?
Albert Cakes Esquire at your service.
You want to do decimators? I mean, after that, like after the money's all paid.
What are you doing here? Everything okay?
I'm not sure. Probably. Fellow came by the farm. Got attacked on the road. He said the Skinner brothers was hanging around. Lots of them. Left Uncle under the teeth back at the ranch.
Who are these two?
Guns for hire. This Skinner's about, we need him.
We ain't got that kind of money, Charles.
Do you want to get robbed for your house?
No, but...
Hey, these Skinners can be nasty. Come on. Mr. Devon, you're with me. Mr. Wayne, this is...
Milton. Jim Milton.
Sir, good to meet you.
We'll be heading up to the Manzanita Post.
Why?
The best smith around is that Norwegian fellow up there.
So they say. You boys ready?
Yes, sir, we're ready.
Good, because you're about to get shot at over a goddamn hammer.
You want to build a house with a sniper rifle, then?
I know old Neil's real well. I'll get you a good deal.
Thank you, sir. All right, then. Let's go buy us some tools.
I know the quickest way. Follow me.
Is your friend a Negro or a Redskin?
I think a bit of both, for what it's worth.
Cash is cash, though it's all the same to me. I saw you getting skittish there, but don't you worry. We're not getting shot at.
Oh, yeah. I know Charles Smith. If he's got cause to be concerned, it's usually good cause.
You got a shotgun messenger sitting right beside you, all right? I suppose you don't know much about robbing caravans.
Not much, I guess. No.
Well, nor do I. But I know a thing or two about protecting them. And if a robber sees some strong men sitting up front, two of them guns behind, then they're gonna wait for the next set of fools to come on through.
Unless they take the guns to mean they're carrying something valuable. Instead of pre-cut timber and some tools.
What? No. Wait. Trust me on this. You are overthinking it. You hire a gun, you hire peace of mind and a deterrent. So I'll sit here looking big and scary, and you can concentrate on the horses.
All right. I'll do just that.
Maybe I've done this kind of thing before, and maybe I can handle a weapon. But I'm not so different from you, partner.
I think you might be.
People wonder how you can handle it, living by your gun. But it's the same as any other occupation, really.
Hey, we're taking the next right up towards Manzanita Post.
Tell me that again.
When I get home, I put my gun on the rack and it stays there. I mean it. It really stays. think about it. My mind's on my wife and the little ones. I'm chopping wood, mending the roof, putting the kids to bed. But when I'm out here, I'm watching the tree line. I got my gun at the ready. And I'm trying to make my employer as comfortable as possible.
That's, real good of you.
You're in good hands. I know this country well.
Good. Am I finally gonna meet this tool maker?
Now, Niels, he's an acquired taste, but boy, can he work metal. Norwegian, you see? Viking blood. Fellas up there used to worship a god with a hammer. Guess it figures they still be making them. I'm not sure how much English he speaks, but Niels knows tools. And he knows me, so we'll see if we can get him to give you some. They won't be free. They won't even be cheap. But they'll be worth what you pay.
There's the spot. Just up ahead.
Okay.
It's some Viking tools you gotta make your tools.
You boys wait here.
After you, Mr. Miller.
Nails, it's me. Willard Wayne.
Okay.
This is my associate, Jim Milton.
Okay.
He heard you was the best. Best smith around. He needs some tools. He's building a ranch house up at Beecher's Hope.
Beecher's Hope, okay.
Have you got any mate?
Okay.
Like I said, an acquired taste, but a heart of gold, then he's the best. You off someplace, Mills?
Okay.
Man, we need definitely someone that.
So Milton is working with Kate's Hardwood and Timber in town. Should I get them to pay you and add it to his bill up there?
Okay.
Come on, let's get moving. Okay.
All right then. Beecher's Hope. They've been trying to sell that property for some time, haven't they? Took a look at it myself, as it so happens. Seemed like a lot of work. Too much for me. But more power to you. Must have seen something in it I couldn't. World needs. Oh.
No! Not William.
Everyone find some cover!
Okay,
Mr. Devin, you okay?
Yes.
Is that the last of them?
I think so. There's more! They got the tools!
Wait, where?
They grabbed this away!
They grabbed one.
Stay here, go out the way. Charles, come on!
Free, okay. That was kind of bold. I break free in everything, and somehow I die.
Okay, let's move. He took
him
down the hill.
That was kind of retarded. Screw you, stupid skinners. guessing.
A few minutes ago, he was chewing my ear off.
He knew what he was getting into.
Did he?
Yeah. Everyone knows.
He sent me.
Later, John.
You all right carrying him?
I got it.
Mr. White, you make me.
Dear Lord, no.
We have to get out of here. You take him in the back wagon. Come on, help me.
All right, let's get out of here.
Oh my God, you stupid elf.
With you.
Leaving poor Devin?
Those were the skin brothers.
I told you I was worried.
Zane said something too. What kind of land have I bought?
It's not the land. The skinners move around. They're here for now.
I thought this kind of bloodshed was meant to be over with. What was all the nonsense about civilization?
This kind of bloodshed is different. Folks have been killed, sure. For good reason and bad. But rarely just for the fun of it.
That was fun for them?
No. Not that time. Most folk don't usually put up with such a fight.
But I hope we put an end to.
There was a caravan. A few months back, massacred.
Uncle!
In the field.
You useless sack of crap.
I was keeping guard.
Really?
Bullcrap.
Whoa. What happened?
Skinner brothers.
Bottom?
Enough. Once this is done, I'll take Mr. Devin back to town. You pull Mr. Wayne buried.
Okay. Be careful.
Well, I will. I'm fairly sure we scared him off for now.
Bad business. Well, we'll be safe together.
Sure. If you say so.
And John, I love you. Don't you forget that.
That main mission? Saw something flash, I thought it might be a main mission far away.
Those plans make any sense?
Oh, sure.
Seems easy enough, I think.
How hard can it be? But I'll tell you what I think, just to be safe.
I'll do the reading and planning, and you do the building.
How did I know you'd try to weasel out of doing any work?
Oh, now, that is plain unfair. It's inaccurate and not what's going to happen. I'm simply going to use what I've got, which is a brain. Or you use what you got, which is less of a brain.
Let's get started.
Well, first thing it says the foundation, which involves moving those heavy wooden joists. Definitely not a job for a man with terminal lumbago, unless you want to dig a 6-foot-deep hole for me when the work day is over.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, well, here comes Charles. Maybe he can lighten the mood a little.
How'd you get on?
I'll be back, but not for a while.
Charles, dear boy, John needs help moving these joists. Now, come on. Get a move on. We gotta get started before the rains come.
You're very annoying.
He's right.
should get on with this.
So do you.
Oh, I know.
And you, Charles, as long as you'll stay with us.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, to this happy home. At least till this fool gets his woman back.
My darling Abigail. I hope you and Jack are doing well. I remain a fool, and I'm sure I shall die a fool. But I'm trying very hard to be something like the man you deserve. I have done something very silly in an effort to impress you. And that is, I've purchased a home. The land you read about in the newspaper up at Beecher's Hope is now ours, and we are going to try our hand at ranching. Mr. Geddes kindly helped me buy the land. I met Uncle while I was coming out of the bank, and while I know your feelings about him, he has been enormously helpful in his own fashion. Charles Smith has also appeared and is unsurprisingly a pillar of strength. Together, we've built you a home. I hope soon to show it to you. I miss you and the boy more than I can express. Please, come back to me. Yours always, John. Uncle, I thought you was... Where the hell?
Where the hell's Uncle? Is he seriously napping all the way out there so I don't see him? This lazy buffoon. Just gonna run the rest of the way. You lazy.
Just one time I hope to find you working. Just once.
Do you believe in reincarnation, John Marston?
No.
Well, I hope and pray to whatever is out there that I get to come back as a youngin. So that when you're old and facing death, I could be some two-penny slave driver that comes along and hastens your journey into the grave. This is a fatal condition I got.
And I'll give you another fatal condition. We don't get on with things around here, and we'll all starve.
Get on with what?
Farming? Ranching? Planting something?
The only thing that this land's good for is grazing.
Grazing?
Yeah, so cows, sheep, goats. Goats is easy, but they taste awful.
I don't like goats. And cows, I've seen enough cows.
Yeah, sheep then. But any livestock, you're gonna need a barn.
Barn'll take three of us 6 months to build.
Oh, you don't build a barn, dumbass. What do you think this is, 1785? You buy one pre-cut just like the house. This is the industrial age. The lumber fellers all have them.
That guy makes me hate the modern world.
Oh, come on. I'll deal with them.
Okay, man, like I used to. Man, I never was that fast. In the Blackwater. Let's go.
Gonna take the path so I don't
take too long to get there. Here's some corn husk idiot, some country rube doesn't know a pre-cut home from an outhouse. And I'm gonna rob him blind. I got respect for it. Because if I saw you walk into my lumberyard, I'd think exactly the same thing.
Think about it? I might actually do this on my own.
Oh, I can't let you do that, John. Let's get robbed again. Oh, no. You need someone with some sense to negotiate. And some charm wouldn't hurt neither.
Oh, and that's you, is it? With your famous way with people?
You're enough debt as it is. I got to help you all I can.
It's my debt. I'll handle it.
Yeah, but if they foreclose on the debt, I'll lose my home. And I do so like it there.
You like it too much. You're far too comfortable.
You ain't even got furniture.
Oh!
I'm sorry, Alpha. How are you?
We need a barn.
A barn? Of course you do. All them potatoes.
We're gonna farm livestock.
What's wrong with you? How many scar-faced loons you got coming in here buying pre-cut homes?
Here, what you think? Have a look.
Maybe that one.
Yeah. An excellent choice. We have a couple already cut and in stock. I'll have it sent to you in Blackwater.
I'm down at Beecher's Hope.
Oh, I'm sorry. Of course, this is my wife, Jerry. You see, she's out. It's great seeing you again, Al.
Yeah, and you, sir. Pleasure as always. Great pleasure. Love your work.
Of course.
How are we going to pay for this?
Same way we pay for everything.
I just wish I could help you, sir. You've been a good customer, and I like you, and David Geddes likes you.
Now,
this man is very annoying.
Can you just give me a few days?
Of course.
I really enjoy begging and watching you make a fool of yourself.
John! Hey!
Is that Sadie Adler? Hey!
John, how are you?
Well, hello, Uncle. Nice to see you.
And you too. Oh, shut up, you old creep.
Listen, Sadie, you got any work? I'm kind of desperate.
Work? How desperate?
I need money. A bunch of money. My debt's climbing.
You up for a fight?
Is it legal?
That's very legal, but it's also pretty dangerous. With you, it'll be fine, but I wouldn't do it on my own.
I ain't got much choice.
All right, then. Come on.
Look after him, Sadie. He's a delicate flower underneath.
That's
tell the bank. There's money coming in. And get a crew to help with that barn.
On good authority, we can find this bounty at Painted Sky.
I know the place.
Okay, I'll follow you. Out there. Burnings, killings, you name it. Not much law except the sheriff of Tumbleweed. He's making a hell of a go of it, but there ain't much there to hold back the chaos. It's real wild, that country.
That ain't much of an advertisement for the place.
It isn't somewhere I vacation, but it's something to behold. If you're inclined, you should take a look.
You know, I had some trouble of my own. That gang you was talking about, they the Skinner brothers.
That's them.
They ain't nice.
Nice? Weren't what I heard about them.
Got a hold of this feller I hired. He didn't die well.
I'm sorry, John.
We fought back. We was too slow was all. I wish we'd done better for him.
I'm sure you did the best you could. I've heard, the kinds of things they do to men. Unspeakable things. I hope that's the last you see of them.
Me too. But if not, I mean to be ready.
That is wise.
You want to hear something? I built my ranch house.
Good for you. Did you make it out of straw bales?
No. It's one of them pre-cut ones. Me and Charles put it up, and Uncle watched, barked the odd order at us. It's solid, though. Real. Getting started.
Woo! John Marston's got his own house.
You should come see it. It's good country, Sadie, despite all that.
I try not to fraternize too much with employees. You know, it sends the wrong message.
Oh, that's what I am now. An employee.
almost like
this. Yeah, painted sky up here.
Looks quiet. Ramon Cortez, you better be here. Let's get down and take a look. You search that barn. I'll take the main house.
Holler if you dare.
Take a barn. Man, why am I always in the barn? Give me pick the lock. You be nice.
Ramon Cortez! We've come for you!
It'll all be over soon.
Hard at
I think
all.
So. He just tried to kill me.
That's about right. Yeah, that's him. Come on. Let's get him to the sheriff. Come on, Ramon. Let's go for a ride. We're going to Rhodes.
Rhodes?
It's different there now.
That hurt. You want money? Gold? My men are meeting me at Newberry Creek. Take me there. I'll pay you good. There isn't any bounty.
Oh, shut up.
So we're going back to Rhodes. Greatest memories there, mostly just Sean. But the place is different, not run by Grays, and they're running me at the brave fights, which should be fine.
This place still gives me the creeps.
Get your horse up here. Ramon Cortez.
Cortez?
Sure did. Well done.
How?
Found him hiding in a pile of shit.
That's about right.
How you doing, Ramon?
Oh, just fine, mister. Hey, how much you want? How much any of you want? I'll give $2,000 in gold to whichever one of you sets me free.
I'm afraid it's a bit late for that, Ramon. You've been a real bad boy. Me and my boys are gonna ride you into San Denis and watch them hang you.
Okay, you think so, mister.
Oh, I know so, Ramon. Take a seat. Help me guard them till my boys arrive and we can get them out of here.
Sure.
Spent years cleaning up this town. Last thing I need is fools like this thinking they can take us back to the bad old days.
Well, you did a good job.
How happy he is. He has to be planning something. He has to know something's going to happen that's still set him free. Doesn't seem a bit worried. There's no way those are random people. Ryan.
Oh, on
three horses?
Thomas,
yeah,
Thomas.
I knew it.
You want their friend back? You have about 10 seconds, Sheriff Thomas. Before we get out of your boots. One.
Don't be a dumb bastard.
Two.
This is a good town now.
Three. There we have it, boys.
Thank you.
God damn it. I knew it.
Jail! Jail! They blew my jail apart. He's gone. He's gone.
God damn it.
We brought him in. Now, Pez, what's up?
He ain't here now, madam. I don't get paid unless he makes it to San Denis.
You want to get shot today as well as Rob, mister?
Are you threatening me?
Why would we bother threatening you?
Get him back and I'll get your money. And another $50 besides.
$100.
$75. I can't go higher.
Done. Let's go, Jim Milton. Mount up.
Come on, then. Where are we going to find him?
He said there were men meeting him at Dewberry Creek. Let's start by looking there.
Sure. You bet. Bad luck with bounties being stolen off of you.
And you're about to have some bad luck with getting punched in the face. He got stolen off both of us.
Someone must have talked.
One of his boys, maybe.
We were sitting ducks, waiting all that time in that Jim Crack jailhouse. I don't like it.
The sheriff's done a lot to bring Rose into line since the time of the Grays and Braithwaite's, but clearly he ain't done enough.
So you think we can trust him?
Yeah. He'll pay up when we come back with Cortez. He's a decent fella.
If we come back with Cortez.
We're coming back with him. Don't you worry about that.
It's not a thing, isn't it? We'll take $200 from a sheriff. Who might be crooked himself to go get a bounty, but we won't take $2,000 from an outlaw just to let him go.
If that kind of offer is tempting to you, then go right ahead, but not when you're on one of my jobs.
I never said I was tempted by it. I just said it was an odd thing, how we take money from one but not the other.
Everyone's got to choose what they're loyal to, themselves, God, the state. If a bounty hunter wants to last, the loyalty's got to be to the one that's issuing the bounties. Plain and simple. I got a reputation for honest work.
So, everyone with a price on their head deserves it, you think?
Sure. No, I don't know. Usually, if I got into who deserved what, second guess every poster, I'd tear out all my hair before I put a rope on anyone. If the price is high enough, you got to trust there's a reason they said it.
I hope that rationale works out for all of us.
Yeah, I think we're here. Or at least close.
Hold up. Down there. Fire.
Yeah.
I'd wager that's them. Hold that horse light.
So, what were you saying?
Stay on the road. Let's find a good vantage point.
Vantage point? What do you mean, sniper?
They must be camping down there.
Why are they hanging around?
Probably waiting for a boat. There's supposed to be a storm coming through, so maybe that's delayed them.
Rats. So what do we do now?
I'm gonna go get them.
You?
Me. You just cover me. I ain't getting you killed out there.
But it's okay for you.
I don't want to die. And besides, those bastards don't look that tough. They look asleep as far as I can tell. I'm gonna go.
You sure about this? just don't seem right.
This is my show, John Marston. Do as you're goddamn told. And shoot well. Yeah. help me load this fool on the horse.
A lot of crazy bastards. Seems Mexico's a tough place.
Too tough for you, John Marston. I'd stay well clear.
Oh, I mean to, Mrs. Adler.
Okay, let's go.
There you are, Missy.
It's about time we collected this bounty.
Second time lucky.
What do you think, Cortez? Do you think more surprises up your sleeve?
You're a dead woman. You're a dead man. They'll almost will not forgive this. Wherever you lie, we will find you. And we will kill you. You.
Since this nice man blew a hole in it. Yeah. Me and the boys will ride him to Saint-Denis right away this time. Come along, Cortez.
Sheriff, before you go.
I'll pay you when I deliver him.
Plus $75.
Exactly. Now, goodbye. Let's go, boys.
I'll see you soon, amigos.
Shut up.
Thanks for this, John.
Can you send my money to the bank for me?
Of course.
I'm supposed to be retired from this.
This? For nothing. Just a simple arrest. Money for old Rove.
If you say so.
See you around, partner.
your reins off, Missy.
Well, since it's an uncle mission, I'm sure it won't be taking that long. But the intent to do the last one was an uncle mission, so... Who knows?
How was your holiday?
I was making money.
You think? You call me lazy.
You've done a great job.
Well, that crew did help.
The house, the barn, look at this place. I can't believe it. Thank you. Thank you both.
This calls for a drink.
Young miss at dancing school has taught the minuet to tread. Young miss at dancing school has taught the minuet to tread. But we go better when we've brought our four-tack to Cathead. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, we'll pump it out, and then all hands to sea. When horn and hounds the forest rends, his pack the huntsman cheers. When horn and hounds the forest rends, his pack the huntsman cheers. As loud as halloo when we send a broadside to Mount Sears. As loud as halloo when we send a broadside to Mount Sears. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, pump it out, and then all hands to see. What's got at sea we spend on shore, on sweethearts and our wives. What's got at sea we spend on shore, at sweethearts and our wives. And then my boys hoist sail for more, thus passes sailors' lives. And then my boys hoist sail for more, thus passes sailors' lives. Come bustle, bustle, drink about, and let us merry be. Our can is full, and pipe it out, and let our hands to see. Yeah!
John! Get out here! Uncle's gone!
He's fine! Let me sleep.
Get out here now!
Man, George must not have a hangover at all.
That fat man will be fine.
No, you won't. Skinners.
You think?
Of course. My guess is they went that way. But my other guess is they know we're coming after them.
What choice do we have?
None. Gotta keep our wits about us. We know this is a trap. Let's go.
I tracked him to the road. Pick up the trail there.
Shit. It's like we forgot about it. Should have been ready.
It happened. There's nothing we can do to try and get him back.
We let our guards down for one moment.
Hush. Up here. You see? Blood.
Dear Lord.
They've gone up towards tall trees. Come on. John, look. We should agree on something. If it's really bad, this might not be about safety.
What the hell are you talking about?
If it's really bad, it might be better to stop the pain.
Jesus, what you mean to...
I mean, you can live a week without a scalp, but it ain't a good week. A gut wound, you can live a month, but it's horrible. What they've done to him might have killed him already, with only hurt to come.
We get him, and we see, okay?
We'll make it his call if we can. But it may be we have to decide, okay?
Okay. Did you hear something?
Yeah.
You think they saw us coming?
I don't know.
Guess we'll soon find out.
We'll be better off going on foot.
Okay. Leave the horses in the trees there. To the trees. Come on.
the right. Two skinners. Look out. Probably. Take one. I'll take the other. They're down.
He better be.
Easy.
And we're looking for something.
Us, most likely. Come on, let's find where they're holding him.
I didn't know you can get those kind of. I didn't know they actually do that with the bow and arrows. I thought it was only a gun thing.
I think I see something. Yeah, that must be their camp.
What do we do?
Let's get up on that boulder. Take a look.
Hang in there, old man.
Okay. I can't see much through this mist. Can you look too?
Hold on. Oh. My God. We gotta go get him.
Careful. Where are they?
I don't care. Come on. Just in time. God damn it. Come on. Down that gully.
sure.
Thank you, boys. Don't mention it. I was dead.
Don't get all sentimental now, old man. And I really think you're dying. It's gonna be okay. A few days, you're gonna be just fine. You're a survivor.
Easy, easy. You'll be fine.
You think they'll be back?
Maybe, but I doubt it. We must have killed most of them. And this is your land.
Was it theirs once?
I don't think so. Another fellow said the Skinners were done about 2 years ago. They're just angry men on a rampage when they got in their way.
Sort of like we used to be.
Yeah, exactly like we used to be.
Maybe we should take up torture.
We got up singing instead of torture. We're gonna be safe here, John. Hmm? You? Your family, you'll be safe.
I hope so. I really do. If she ever comes back.
Mission, God damn it.
You're I
he always did have that fine way with words.
You doing all right, son?
Sure, Pop. Can I go see the house?
Yeah, this episode's gonna be sure. A bit longer than usual, then. Where's this mission?
Give him some time. He'll warm up. Got a place you got here.
It's yours.
Ours. I should see about that boy.
Who's my new rival?
Oh, that's Rufus. He's loyal, dumb, and angry, so he reminded us of you.
That's your idea of a joke, miss?
I guess.
Okay, so it was like just see Abigail and Jack kind of mission. Okay, but that's the end of today's episode here. Hope everybody has a lovely day or night. If you didn't, I hope this video cheered you up. Please like and subscribe if you have not written. You don't have to. You do. You can always unsubscribe later. Goodbye.